First, open the symbol editor. Now go to File, New Library. Type a name for your library and click Save. From the left panel, select the library you just created. Then, click Create New Symbol. Type in a name for your symbol and hit OK. Now grab the draw tool according to your design requirement and draw a basic shape for your symbol. Using a reference image or datasheet, we'll now add pins. Click on the Draw Pins tool. For each pin, enter a pin name. Next, enter a pin number. Set the electrical type. For example, choose input for input pins. Choose the graphic style. And choose the right orientation. Then, place the pin where it belongs. For negative input, do the same. Only change the pin name and number. Four outputs. First, change the pin name and number. And then, change the electrical type to output. Next, change the orientation to left. For negative output, only change the pin name and the number. For battery connections, first change the pin name and number. Set the type to bidirectional. And then place it as needed. Similarly, do for the negative terminal of the battery. Once done, you can rearrange them to create some space in between. Just use the Select tool and select all the pins and drag the pins where you want. Next, select the rectangle shape and adjust the shape as required. Now, hover over the symbol and press E to open its properties. In the pop-up window, set the symbol value. If a footprint exists, link it here. If not, don't worry, we'll create one next. Add a datasheet link if you have one. Next, add some short description. And enter some keywords to help with search. Click OK to save the changes. Next, rearrange the labels as needed. Once everything is done, click Save and then close the editor. To test it out, create a new project. Click Add Symbol. Search for the one you just made and add it to your schematic. Now, let's build a matching footprint. Open the footprint editor. Go to File and then New Library. Select Global and hit OK. Now, name your library and click Save. Next, select it from the side panel and click on New Footprint. Now select the footprint which is named as Untitled and then right-click on it and rename the footprint. Next, use the Select tool to move all labels away from the center so we get better visibility. Now from the grid drop-down, choose 0.2 mm as your grid size. Select F.Silkscreen. Next, grab the Draw tool according to your design requirement. Now, draw the outer rectangle. Based on the datasheet, it should be 28 mm by 17.2 mm. Then draw a second inner rectangle, 23 mm by 14 mm. Select it, move it to the center of the first one. Now change the grid to 0.0254 millimeters and draw a third rectangle, 23 millimeters by 8.92 millimeters, and move it to the center of the second one. Next, click on Add Pad and place a pad. Now, hover over it and press E to open Pad Properties. Next, select Pad Type to Through Hole, Shape to Circular, Diameter to 1.4 millimeters, Hole Shape to Round, Hole Diameter to 1 millimeter, and then click OK. Now place the pad as needed. Next, duplicate the pad and place it wherever you need. And assign the correct pin numbers according to your datasheet. Once you're done placing all the pads, delete the two inner rectangles. We don't need them anymore. Now select F.Courtyard and draw a rectangle around the footprint. Then go to F.Fab and draw an inner rectangle. Next, move all labels inside the footprint neatly and hit Save, and then close the editor. Open the symbol editor again and load your symbol. Hover over it and press E to open the properties window. Now to link the footprint to the symbol, click on Footprint. Now select the footprint and click OK. After linking, click OK, then save it and then close the editor. To preview your work, open a test project. Add the symbol you created. Next, go to the PCB editor and import it to check the footprint. I've also added a 3D model to mine. If you're not sure how to do that, check out my previous video. The link is in the description. And that's it. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more helpful videos.